question of the day, how do you feel when you bust out of a poker tournament? It's the trooper, so on and so forth. Back here for the restart, day two of this Deep Stack event number one. What's this? Oh, look what Lady Trooper sent me. Lady Trooper sent me a little thing, a little gift. Starts at 11, it's 10:22. No fooling around today, going straight to the Illy Cafe. We're gonna get the same sandwich and the same coffee as yesterday. Let's go. Know that sandwich is way too expensive. $12 for that is absurd. However, I was sort of arm twisted into it yesterday because of circumstances, and then I ran pretty well at the end of the tournament. So I'm not superstitious. I don't believe in luck, but why mess with it? The only problem is today they gave me the wrong damn sandwich. I ordered a bacon, egg, and cheese. I got a sausage, egg, and cheese. It was actually pretty damn good though. It was probably better than the bacon, egg, and cheese. So, hey, the good news is, even though I was starting to freak out because they were taking forever, it's only 10:45 in the AM right now. 15 minutes until we kick off day two. There's music right behind me. I hope that's not copyright striking this damn video, or not strike, but claiming. And yeah, now that we're here, now that we're calm, now that we have coffee, by the way, I hate when people say that, we, now that I am here, now that I am calm, fed, and I have coffee, I forgot the rest of the statement. I was too worried about semantics. First break, 4 minutes remain on the break. Had to get a coffee. It doesn't look right. It doesn't taste right either. What the? I'm gonna have to go with it. I have 380,000. The blinds are gonna be 15,000, 15,000, 10,000, and there are 32 remaining. So 45 got paid, and the next hour is gonna be crucial. 2 minutes and 45 seconds. I don't have time to get another coffee. This is just gonna have to do. I don't know, it looked weird when I looked in it. I don't know what's going on, but it doesn't matter now. Yo, we gotta go. See ya in, well, hopefully 2 hours on the next break. Let's go. All right, we got that second break of the day going. We're gonna go back to 30,000, 30,000, 15,000 on the blinds. I can't remember one break to the next. I don't remember how many chips I had the last time we took a break. But I have 1.27 million chips at the moment. I had 1.5, 1.535. Now I have 1.27. So 1,270,000. Probably more importantly, there are 16 remaining. Is this? This must be a public sidewalk. If that's part of the Venetian, they just let them sleep right there? So 16 remain. We're this close. this close to another final table. Will we make it through? I hate when people say that. Will we? Who is we? Will I make it through to the final table? Stay tuned till next break, I guess. Probably gonna have to hit that Moon Palace action again if I survive until dinner break. On another note, it's 77 degrees and sunny. Got a few of those little white clouds. I don't remember general science. I don't remember the difference between cumulonimbus and I don't even remember another one. Is Cirrus one? Is Cirrus a type of cloud? I don't know, Google it. Look up your types of clouds. Got about 4 minutes left on break here. Out here in front of the gondola action. All right, so the question of the day, I say that like there's a question of the day every day. Today there's a question of the day, which is, how do you feel when you bust out of a poker tournament? I mean, it probably depends on when and how you bust out, right? I think it's only natural when you do bust out of a poker tournament, especially the longer you play, the more true this is. But I think it's only natural to ask yourself, what could you have done differently? And then even if you made a decision that was 100% the right thing to do, it's very easy to even question that. Like, what if I had just done something ridiculous and folded or whatever, you know what I mean? So anyway, that's kind of how I feel at the moment, but at the same time, I feel pretty good. It's a little before 6 p.m. at the moment, and 427 players started this tournament, and I finished, drumroll, better than you're expecting, I bet. What do you think your guess is? Where did I finish? Ninth. So I came up with a new term today. It's called non-final table ninth. Let me break it down to you. We are 10-handed. There are five at my table and five at the other table. There's a guy over there with about 250,000 chips or something in that range. When we lose one more, we're gonna converge and make it a nine-handed final table, right? So I am in the big blind with 1,050,000 chips. So I'm in the big blind. The big blind is 50,000. The ante is 50,000. And the cutoff raised to 150,000. The button calls 150,000. Small blind folds. And I have pocket eights. So I end up shoving all in. The cutoff pretty readily folds, and the button thinks about it for a while. And while the button is thinking about it, the short stack of the other table gets busted out. So he is now 10th place. And the button thinks about it, and finally he calls ace jack, jack on the flop. So I'm ninth, $2,607, $2,607. So I end up profiting $2,207. I mean, that's great and everything, but so what did I, did I final table? Technically, did I final table? Is that a final table finish? I think it is. I think it is. I went out ninth. We were just in the process. We were getting ready to be in the process of converging. Wow. Got all kind of bell action going. 6 p.m. bell action going. So, of course, I'm thinking to myself, man, if I had just seen the guy go bust, you know, before I shove, maybe it would be better to converge to the nine-handed final table. 10th and 9th pay the same amount of money. The next pay jump was 8th. So, and I think it was like 3,200 or something. I don't even know for sure. First place was 29,000. I mean, when you adjust for the big blinds, I have a million and fifty. It's 125. It's like 83,000 big blind. So 830,000 chips would be 10 big blinds. So maybe I had like 12 or 13 big blinds when you figure the ante into it. So anyway, that's it. That's the end of event number one at the Venetian. So if I'm not mistaken, correct me if I'm wrong. You can't correct me because I'm not wrong, I'm right. I played a tournament. I basically bubbled it. I went out like 7 or 8 before the money. And then I played 3 more and I cashed all 3. Final table, then a 26th, then final table. I mean, you can call it final table if you want to. If you don't want to, don't. Call it whatever you want to call it. Call it checkers if you want. I don't give a shit. 9th place. Kind of feels like poker tournaments is the place to be. For me. That rhymes. All right, let's go. The only question is, do I deserve Moon Palace? Should I have some Moon Palace action? Is that what it's called, Moon Palace? I think it's called Moon Palace. Why do I always not ever know the name of the place? Yo, funny story. It really is funny how these things happen, how they come together sometimes. But I'm sitting over there eating the Moon Palace, and my camera is just sitting there on the counter, on the little mini tripod. It's just sitting there. It's off, but the lens is pointing towards the restaurant across the walkway there. It's called like Marjordomo or some shit. I don't even know. Probably some overpriced strip crap, but what do I know? I have no idea what it is or if it's good or not. So then some guy, like manager type dude, comes walking across the walk, and he's like, "Excuse me, sir, are we filming the front of the restaurant?" And so I picked up the camera and twisted it to show him that it was off, and I said, "No, we're not filming anything." And he was like, "Oh, okay, I was just making sure because we have strict rules." I just continued eating. I didn't even look at the guy at that point. So he turns and walks back to the restaurant. I don't really think much about it until I finish the last 2 bites and hop on the escalator to come up here. And it dawns on me that he said, "Are we filming the front of the restaurant?" Didn't we just talk about this a few minutes ago? Now that we're here, now that we're calm, now that we have coffee. By the way, I hate when people say that, "we." Will we make it through? I hate when people say that, "will we." Who is we? Or a little earlier in this vlog, or was that yesterday? I hate when people say that, we, when it's just me. You know what I mean? And then I realized that it sounded like he was trying to be polite, but actually I think he was being condescending. So, that's all, that's the whole story. And I said, "No, we are not filming anything." Even though I didn't even think about that he said that, but that's just funny. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. It is eerie and quiet as... I'll see you next time.